Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this video today, I want to go over a few different ways that you can use large language models to expand prompts. So there's a few ways that you could do this. So first up, we're going to be taking a look at the Stable Diffusion Web UI Prompt Generator. So this extension is available within the Extensions tab, and if you just click Available Scripts and Load From, you should be able to find it there, or you can install it directly from the URL. But basically, this extension uses GPT-2 and has been trained on Stable Diffusion prompts to basically you provide it with a short prompt and it will make it longer and add all sorts of relevant details. It's a good alternative to say like the styles dropdown where you might have lots and lots of styles to choose from. You can actually just let a large language model kind of fill in the rest of the information for you. So this extension comes with two models preloaded to it, but there's lots of models available on Hugging Face that you can add. And I'll go over that in just a minute. But it's a very similar technology to what is being done within the Focus Stable Diffusion interface that uses GPT-2 to basically process the prompts. So to use this extension, you'll just go ahead and install it and then reload your UI. And then all you need to do is just put in a start of the prompt and it will do the rest of the heavy lifting for you. So I'm gonna put in a photo of an astronaut in a comma, and then just go ahead and I'm gonna click this use punctuation because I find it a little bit easier to read. And it'll add commas between each of the prompts along the way here. So it's basically just generated all these prompts that we could then go ahead and send over to text to image and then generate an image and see what it looks like, which we can see here looks pretty cool, all starting from just a simple term of a photo of an astronaut. So just to kind of explain what's going on behind the scenes here is if you've ever worked with large language models, you might be familiar with a few of these, so I won't go on too long about it. But the most important ones will be like the temperature. This is how creative the model is. A higher value will make it more creative, but more likely to hallucinate, whereas a lower value will be more deterministic. And then you can also have the repetition penalty, so it doesn't repeat the same words over and over, and so on. And you can also determine how many prompts you want to generate, whether it's 5, more, or less. This blacklist is also really important. So say, for instance, you don't want to use some artist styles, for example, in your prompts, or you want to always make sure that you say drop the term sharp focus, for example, you would just add this to the blacklist file, which is in the root directory of the extension. Then it will basically look for this term and then just remove it from the prompt. So that's with the prompt generator extension. Now, if you want to add other models, it's actually pretty easy to do that. So I added one here just for testing purposes, but you'll just go to the root directory and then modify this models.json file, and you can find lots of these GPT-2 based models available on Hugging Face. So there's a few ways you can find them. Hugging Face is kind of a little bit difficult to search through sometimes. You can actually filter based on a data set, so you can see other models that were fine-tuned based on a particular Stable Diffusion prompt data set. We can see here there's 41 different models that you could check out. Otherwise, you could also just simply search within models prompt generator, and you could also find some other relevant results. But basically, you'll just take in the creator's name and the name of the model, and you place that there, what the tokenizer is, and then you can give it a title. It doesn't have to necessarily be always the author itself. You can go ahead and define it however you want. And just one last note on this process is that, you know, if you have lots of images that you've already generated, it might be worth exploring, you know, extracting the prompt from those images and actually training your own GPT-2 model based on your particular style, if there's a certain thing that you're looking for there. So that's a really cool extension I just thought I'd share. So that's with GPT-2. So next up, I'm gonna go ahead and go over the ChatGPT Utilities extension. So this extension is not available within the extension, so you will have to install it from the URL. You basically just go ahead and put the URL of the GitHub repository and then click install. and then it will be added to your system. And then you're just going to want to make sure that you go to the settings, and then all the way down here to ChatGPT utilities, and set in your OpenAI API key. And then you can go ahead and start expanding on prompts. So just make sure that you reload the UI as well too. So let me just go ahead and click refresh here. And once this is loaded, we'll have everything cleared out. And then if we go ahead and type into the prompt box here, a photo of an astronaut, comma. If you go down to script, you'll see ChatGPT here. And then the author here has a few different templates that you can use. So you can modify these if you'd like. And then they also have an answer precision. So I'm just gonna go ahead and say, make a color description. And that's basically what the prompt is. And then as far as this precision, so this is basically just the temperature. Specific is at a temperature of 0.5, normal is at 1.0, dreamy is 1.25, and a hallucinating is at 1.5. And then you can also do the response count. This is basically how many images you want to create. So I'm just going to go to 2. And then there's some other options here. They're fairly self-explanatory. So I'm going to go ahead and just click generate, and then I'm going to pop over to the Windows installation here so you can see what's going on. And if you can see here, here's the system prompt, and then here's the prompts that were returned from ChatGPT that basically expanded the prompt to then create these two images. And you can always see the prompt itself. You don't always have to go to the command line or a console. You can just see it right below the image. So pretty cool. Again, there's lots of ways that you can expand on this. You can take the prompt and change three words somewhere in the prompt. I'm curious to see how this is going to go with a short prompt, but let's go ahead and have some fun here. All right. It's still a photo of an astronaut. I didn't know if it's going to be something completely different. Photo of a cosmonaut. There we go. An illustration of an astronaut. So yeah, that's a neat way to create more diverse images there. So that's the ChatGPT utilities. The author here has a lot of great information on how to use this extension as well too. One thing I do want to note, that I had some issues whenever it came to installing or setting up this extension, is because it's using an old version of OpenAI, the old endpoints. So if you are using Python's the pip library, it's 0.028, which was all the way back in September 25th, 2023, all that long ago in AI terms, of course, but that's completely different endpoints. So the version of OpenAI that I had on my system was a newer version. So in order to make this extension work, I just had to go to the root directory of the extension and then just put in the terms OpenAI migrate. And it will actually update all the endpoints within the code to work with the latest OpenAI version that's available. So if you have any issues with it, that might be one, and was fairly easy to fix. So last up, or actually one more that I want to talk about, is the use of Ollama. So Ollama is a open source application, and they have lots of models available. You can browse through all of them here on their site, but one that I came across was a Stable Diffusion one that was created. I believe it was based on Mistral. So all you have to do is just basically do this Ollama run, and then it will go ahead and expand on a prompt. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. So I have Ollama. Let me just clear that out. Ollama, and then Ollama list to get the right one here, Ollama run, and then here we go. So this is running now. So you could just go ahead and say copy this, and then it will go ahead and expand upon the prompt in a short way. I don't find it to be too verbose with its responses, but it's one that definitely can work, you know. So let me just go ahead and refresh this, or I could have turned off the ChatGPT script. I just didn't want that overriding anything at all. So let me go ahead and just paste that in there, click generate, and then we have a photo that was expanded upon, or a prompt that was expanded upon based on Ollama. So yeah, another way that you can easily expand upon a prompt. Again, you could also consider fine-tuning your own model based on prompts and use this sort of method. And so the last method is a fairly obvious one, but I just wanted to touch on it because it's relevant to this video, is if you have ChatGPT or Claude or any other service, yeah, you can just provide it some Stable Diffusion prompts that you found generate fairly good images, and then just ask the model, you know, here are some example prompts. Now I want to make a prompt, but make it, you know, work for photos of a dog, and then it will go ahead and change all the terms there accordingly to give you some good results that you can always just paste into the prompt box. So that's it. Everything that I just wanted to cover on using large language models to expand on your prompts. If you have any questions, drop a line in the comments. Please don't forget to hit that like or thumbs up button if you like the video. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.